Hello and welcome back to Shamrock Valley. Currently on our way to our field that we combined the other day. Got the 6910S in the baler. Fortunately the first bale is going to be green. So we've still got some hay in here. I think I actually preferred the 17 route in some ways. Where it changed to whatever you were then baling. Not sure how well this is going to yield straw wise. Fairly, I think. Going this way round for a reason, we shouldn't send the bales flying down the hill, so they can roll straight back into the bale with a bit of luck. See how many we get off there. Bale over that side there. Annoying, but that's the way it is. Thin straw so we can go a bit quicker. Don't do too badly for bales by the looks of it. Trying to wallop the gate with a baler. You haven't got to plough this field this time around. It's done now. The speed you want, it goes right at the point where the tractor changes gear, annoyingly. Much like real life in that respect, actually. Generally what happened there with this type of gearbox. So the varios come in handy for certain jobs. You always seem to be at the limit of one gear and too low down for the next one. Especially anything to do with potatoes. Bales aren't rolling. The anti-roll bale mod is doing its job for us. We have got another small job to do if we get time today. It's doing its job, that one's decided it doesn't want to sit and stay. A bit like my dog. Cleared. More bales than I thought there was going to be. have to get the blade back to the cattle yard. Not before time, because we're nearly out. It should be a common occurrence where I used to work. We've had a bad year. Just about out of straw before harvest. Probably the same for a lot of livestock farms. They've had a wet winter. One more headland to get off. In the middle of the field won't take long. Well, she should do our bailing with a John Deere 590 and 6920S. In later days, a Puma 165. Both CVT gearboxes, also apply CVX, give them the right titles. Set the corner this time, it'll make it a bit easier. Should know that I dumped that there. I don't think we'll be selling any of these bales somehow. Gonna need them all. On the contract fields as well. I wonder if someone would be able to bring out some sort of script mod to sort that little one out. Do something to the game to do it. I imagine it's hard coded in somewhere. Bales across the field. Harvest time. Let's just give that one a little tap. Has missed any? It hasn't. It's good. Skip across the field now. Every swath, other swath. Is that how we used to do it? So we've now got turns tight on the headlands. Look on the encounter afterwards and see how many bells we've got. Going anyway. I'll have to put them back in the feed wagon again. It's a filler. See if we can get it to the right place this time to empty out a park bale. Not if we're going to end up with the same problems on the hay. First time we'll let one out going up the field. Since we've been in the middle here. Bit up first so we can get the rest of the field done without running on top of them all. Don't want to run on swaths, straw swaths any more than you have to when you buy them. Makes them damn hard to pick up. Used to be a frequent bugbear of mine, the harvest steward's track and all over the trailers. Pick up and in turn that gave me headaches playing the fields. Certainly not short of them, which is good. Back on ourselves this time. Let's go one swath away. Right at the end of one again. Done then. Just those two there. Several bells to clear up. Get the bug blame off video though. Still got a field of canola to harvest as well. Have a look and see what other contracts are knocking about. And of course we've got this field to get ready to drill and drill in the autumn. So it's slightly early to harvest on here next year. Probably be canola on this field. headed somewhere. So quick when it decides to stop loaded. Otherwise it does skid for quite a good distance, this one. Two long ones and a little baby one down the bottom there. And we're done. Get this back to the yard and we need to go and pick our 7930 up. Which is still the combine. With some wheat on board actually, which is what we need to get rid of. Let's sell that, because the price was good when we done that contract. Display up so we can see what's going on. I think we're in luck this time. Just saw a small bit lying down here we'd missed. There we go. While we use this bag, we can actually empty the 2941 in. Have 27 barrels on this field. It's not too bad. Should be enough to keep us going, I hope. Too many so far. We almost got through 1 year on here. Down the other farm. Let's put this alongside here for now. Getting good hedge hopping on here. 7930 is in here. With 5,500 litres on board. Let's sell this on a video so we can see what we earn from it. Can't be accused of cheating the funds then. The same sell point as last time. Tip and sell this, and then that's where we'll be finishing this video. The texture issue going on up there. The pedestrian this time. Not too much bigger traction trailer to get in there. See how many pennies we can earn from this. $5,323. That'll do me nicely. But that is where we're going to be leaving this video. So for now, I'll say thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you again in the next one. Goodbye for now.